Hello students, welcome to my channel. Let us continue the discussion of GATE 2018 question papers. This section is from agricultural processing variant food under 1 mark section, 1 mark each question. There are 7 questions. Let us quickly review it and also find out the answers or solutions for each question. The first questions under this category is like this: convective film heat transfer coefficient h of air, where thermal conductivity is equal to 0.025 watt per meter per kelvin, in watt per meter square per kelvin, when trapped between two parallel glass pans in a window, 1.5 millimeter apart, is 3.75, 16.67, 37.52, 60.21. There are four options are there. Let us quickly check. These are the two parallel pans, or you can say glass pans. So where actually the distance, the gap between the two pans is 1.5 millimeter, and in between there is a film. So you can say trapped, or water is trapped in between these two pans, so window pan. It is saying the thermal conductivity is given between these two, film. You can say this is the film. So K is given. This is the K, 0.025 watt per meter per kelvin, and distance is given 1.5 millimeter. So it's very simple. So as you know, the convective film heat transfer coefficient H is equal to K. K is the thermal conductivity in this case, so K divided by thickness of the film. This is the thickness of the film given, 1.5 millimeter. Then you can just quickly find out H is equal to 0.025. The thickness of the film should be in meter, because if you see the dimensions are watt per meter per kelvin, so and it should be watt per meter square. So it's very simple. If you don't know the this formula, again you can see there are two data that are given only. One is 0.025 watt per meter per kelvin, and you need watt per meter square, per meter square per kelvin. You need this one, and this should be something into something, or something divided something. In you here see the minus 2 is here, so here actually minus 1 is given, so something is needed divided by meter, then it will be fine. So this one is K, and this one is the thickness. This is very simple. So from here actually you can find out easily, even if you don't know the actual formula. Here actually the heat transfer coefficient is watt, the heat watt per meter square, means area per kelvin. So therefore the answer is 16.67. next question: log mean temperature difference LMTD correction factor F is applicable to spiral tube heat exchanger, plate heat exchanger, steam jacket kettle, evaporator tubes. Basically log mean temperature is logarithmic average of temperature difference between the heat exchanger plates, basically. So if there are two liquids passing through, one is heating another one, then between them two heat the temperature difference, so if you see heat, there might be counter flow or concurrent flow. So it might be like this or this. So T1 or T2 between the two sides, or T1, T2. So it might be the concurrent or counter current. So between these two, whatever the difference between the temperature divided by logarithmic temperature T1 by T2 is equal to log mean temperature difference, which is very important to calculate the heat transfer coefficient and other things, the heat exchanger capacity and efficiency, etc. But what is the correction factor? So if you see, there are certain either it's concurrent or co-current. So concurrent or counter current. But there are some certain it's called the either one pass, all the heat exchangers either one pass or multi pass. So there are different type of heat heat exchangers. So now if we will see in one pass either the flow is concurrent or counter current, but in multi-pass, so there is a mixture of one pass counter current and concurrent flow current. Therefore, the temperature difference law LMTD is different because of the temperature. If there are number of passes are there, so this is one pass, multi pass. Now we'll see which one is generally for multi pass heat exchangers correction factors are required, because LMTD will be different. Therefore, to make it more efficient calculation, there is a correction factor is added. Now we'll see which one is multi pass. First of all, spiral to heat exchanger, that is not multi-pass, only single pass will be there. Either it will be concurrent or counter current. Next one is steam jacketed kettle, which one is only single pass. Therefore, it cannot be the correct answer, because here actually the correction factor is not required. Then plate heat exchanger, here you can see there is number of plates are there. So there actually it can be multi-pass, where actually the concurrent and counter current flow both can exist. Therefore, correction factors are required. And evaporative tubes, here actually only either concurrent flow or counter current flow is done. That's why there is no correction factors required. Therefore, the answer will be plate heat exchanger, where actually it's multi-pass flow is there. Therefore, correction factors are required to counter the irregularity due to its geometric irregularities. Therefore, the answer is plate heat exchanger. Next question: which one of the following statement related to parboiling of paddy is not correct? So let us during parboiling, what happens actually? The paddy is soaked in water, then it's preheated, then it's again dried, then it's milled basically. So there are different type of parboiling, single parboiling and double parboiling also are done. Generally, parboiling is nothing but boiling the paddy before milling. So now what does it happen actually during the paddy parboiling? So let us see, there are four points, which one is not correct, we'll see. First is irreversible granule swelling occurs during heating. It is true, because when it's parboiled or boiled, the grain becomes little swelled and it's irreversible. The size becomes little more because of swelling, because it takes more water. So that it becomes, then after that drying, still it becomes more in size. That's why it's not correct answer, because it's right. Next is parboiling process is used to salvage wet and damaged paddy. It's also correct. That means it's not the correct answer, because generally in parboiling process, you have to pre-soak the paddy before parboiling. That's why the wet paddy is good, or damaged paddy also, because of difference in you can say the moisture content. Damaged, some of the things are damaged when it's parboiled. Its effect is done good. That's why the parboiling process is used to salvage, means to recover some of the wet and damaged paddy. It's also correct. That's why this is not the answer for this one, because we have to find the wrong one. Next one is parboiled rice takes less time to cook as compared to raw rice due to starch gelatization. Generally, the starch gelatization occurs, so it becomes little sticky and also it becomes very hard. So therefore, when you parboiled rice is cooked, it takes more time, not the less time. Therefore, this is wrong statement. So it takes more time for cooking. Therefore, this might be the correct answer. So let us see, this is correct. Therefore, this is the correct answer. Now let us see the last choice, that is milling yield of paddy increases due to starch gelatization. Definitely, due to starch gelatinization, what happens actually, it becomes little hard, and during the milling actually less breakage occurs, and also the bran, rice bran is actually separated from the paddy. So therefore, milling of the paddy increases. That means less rice is lost. Therefore, the correct answer is parboiled. So this is not the answer. Therefore, this is the answer for this question. So next question: in refining of the rice bran oil for edible purposes, neutralization process is carried out mainly to remove There are four options: wax and organic impurities, gums and mucilage, saturated glycerides, free fatty acid. Let us see what are the processes by which actually the rice bran oil is refined for our edible purposes. Basically, in the refining process, a lot of impurities like and also the unhealthy food compositions are removed. So basically, the saturated glycerides, free fatty acids, gums, wax and other things, everything is actually removed through the process actually. Out of the different process by which these things are removed, let us explain about it. First is the, what are the different processes of oil refining process in rice bran? First is winterization, where actually in this process, waxes and saturated triglycerides are removed. Therefore, this is not the answer actually, because this is winterization is the process where actually and waxes are also removed. So therefore, this is not the correct answer. These two are not correct answer. Next, degumming. Degumming is a process where actually the phospholipids of or gums or mucilage are actually removed. Therefore, this is also B, also not the correct answer. Next, different other process is bleaching, where actually color bodies, trace metals and residual soaps are removed actually. After neutralization process and other things, actually whatever the soaps and other things are made actually, they are removed through bleaching. Also, there are bleaching is not the process where actually free fatty acids are removed. Next is the neutralization. This is the process where actually free fatty acids are removed. Therefore, the correct answer is this one, D. But let us see another process is there, that is deodorization actually, where actually contaminants, odor, volatile compounds are actually removed from the rice bran oil for healthy oil production. So in neutralization process actually generally there are different free fatty acids which are not good for health, so generally removed by adding potassium hydroxide at a particular temperature, so that the different free fatty acids are made into soap and they are removed after that easily from other processes. So therefore the answer for this question is free fatty acids. Next question. Which one of the following chemicals is not used for fumigation in either horizontal or vertical storage structure to kill insects? So there are different processes by which you control the insects and other things for the storage structures. So basically, let us see what are the options for this one: methyl bromide, phosphine, phostoxin, and silver sulfate. So what are these actually? Let us see for fumigation purpose. So first is methyl bromide, which is a organic pesticide fumigate for quarantining the insects or any other harmful creatures around the surrounding the storage structures. Next one is phosphine, colorless flammable toxin, which are generated from phosphine is PH3, which is made from phosphoric acid. So PH3 is the phosphine. So this one is phosphine. So therefore, phosphine is also used for fumigation because a colorless flammable fume generated. Next one is the phostoxin, which is also called as aluminium phosphide, which is an inorganic toxic fumigate used to control rat, mole, rabbit, or any other insects also. Therefore, phostoxin is also not the answer. Next one is the silver sulfate. Silver sulfate is the ionic compound of silver, which is used for silver plating. So this is not used for any type of fumigation or killing the insects. Therefore, the methyl bromide, which is a fumigate, phosphine is a fumigate, so that is not answer. Phostoxin is also used for fumigation or killing the insects. Therefore, this is not the answer. The silver sulfate is the answer because it is used for silver plating, not for fumigation. Therefore, the answer is silver sulfate. Next question. Where is the following agricultural food byproducts in column 1 with their respective value added products in column 2? There are two columns are there, just you to match. It's very simple one here actually. If you also don't know the correct answer, if you know the two or three, then other can be easily find out by just general understanding. First is banana seed stem. You know banana seed stem is eaten by, it's a vegetable, you can say. So this is the inside the banana tree. There is white cylindrical structure. So salicylic rod type. So you can use for food. So basically, whenever food is there, some starch might be there. So unless it's a protein is food, because protein is not there, therefore the protein might not be inside food. Is not silicon tetraglutide is not food. Starch is a food. So generally, since we eat it, therefore the pseudostem might be the starch. Even if you don't know, but you just mark it. Therefore, we'll see later. Coconut shell. Coconut shell is the very hard structure of the coconut, which we break then with the coconut one. So that's why coconut shell should be hard. So here it is generally, if you see, coconut shell contains furfural, which is a aldehyde of furan. So this is also used for bacterial food, or you can just use it for inorganic feed to the bacteria. So by decomposition, therefore furfural is the answer for coconut shell, that meat waste. So this is the only simplest one, because meat contains protein, so it's a protein food. Meat waste means the remaining of the meat, so that's why meat waste is 100% protein food. This is actually, you must be thinking that protein is there means some meat. So meat waste contains protein food. Next is the rice husk. Rice husk contains a silicon tetrachloride, actually, which is a very simple one, because it's a, just if you see, very silicon type things, actually. It's in pure form, though silicon is not good for this is toxic, but this is used for like photovoltaic and other preparation. So pure silicon is made from this silicon tetrachloride. So rice husk is silicon tetrachloride. Therefore the answer will be, it's a very simple one, so if you don't know, just see here and there, then you can easily find out. So therefore the correct answer will be C3 4. Okay. P3, Q4, only one is here, so B is the answer. Therefore, the answer will be B. Next question. Molecular diffusivity or DAV of water vapor in air is 2.6 into 25 minus 5 meters square per second over an effective distance of generally DAV is given here. So DAV is given, but conflictive mass transfer is not given. DAB is given. And also L is given, that is the effective distance, or you can say that is also given. But for finding out the Seriot number, we know Seriot number is NSH. So NSH will be equal to H divided by K into L by DAB. So DAB. So DAB and L are given, but K is not given, or convective anything is not given. Therefore, what we will do, and also the density and coefficient of viscosity is given. So we know actually Reynolds number, we can find out. Reynolds number is calculated for finding out Seriot number. There is a empirical formula is given. Therefore, we need V for this, but V is not given here. Now I have just taken DAV by L, because V is meter per second, just I have taken this one. Taken this one, that is for finding out Reynolds number. So putting all the values, Reynolds number actually can be, rho is given, that is the density of air, DAV is given, mu is given. So I can get it, that is 1.56, I don't know whether it is correct or not, but still. This is the way, actually I will doubt on this, but still you can find out. Similarly, the schemic number SC, that is mu by rho DAB, all everything is given, so you can easily find out the schemic number, that is 0.641. This is correct. So once you find out, you can use the formula for Seriot number, that is 2 plus 0.55, Reynolds number to the power half, schemic number to the power 1 by 3. Just I have used this one, then you can easily get it. There is answer is 2.5923. The answer will be around 2.6. Generally, I checked though the convective mass transfer coefficient is not given, therefore it's little difficult to get the serum number, but there are other options are there, so where actually you can find out the serum number, but this is just I have not gone into the details. Little doubt is here because in the official answer the answer is given one is the answer, but I have little doubt whether one will be the answer or not, because the serum number for water vapor is around more than 2.45, something like this. So should I check everywhere? So it might not be the correct one, but still I have doubt, so I am not sure, but if I get later on I will just update this one. Therefore the answer for this question I feel is 2.6, not 1 actually, as given by the official key of the GATE 2018. So this 1 is given, but I don't know how they calculated 1, so I have doubt. So I asked some students to claim for it, but I don't know whether they claim for it or not. The question, my answer might be different, but 1 is little doubtful for me. Therefore for me is 2.5923 is the answer. So that's for all for this section of dairy processing and food engineering. I will update all the two marks questions later on, and if I find by the meantime this correct one, I will update this one, or maybe they will update their answers. Until then, goodbye. Please like and subscribe to my channel.